l'adjectif avec une préposition et un nom ou un infinitif. Okay? So, let's see now. So, it's actually quite interesting because it is possible to construct, and we've been covering quite many, many different situations and many type of adjectives. And in this video, we can see that it's possible to construct a sentence or a structure with an adjectif that will be followed by une préposition and then un nom or a noun or an infinitive form of a verb. Okay, so adjectif, préposition and then nom ou infinitif. Okay, so when we talk about les prépositions, so we think about a, de or then en, but then keep in mind that in most of the cases it will be de. Okay, but it's possible with a, de, and en. For instance, je suis content de partir. Okay, so in that case, you can see that you've got this content, okay, and then it followed by this de preposition and the verb partir. Je suis content de partir. Or then it could be, elle est fière de moi. Okay, so you've got this adjective here, fière, and then de. And in that case, you've got moi, so le pronom personnel tonique. Or then it could be, c'est plein de vitamines. Plein, adjectif, de, and then vitamine, substantive, or a noun. Or then, c'est facile à dire. Okay, so in that case, you've got your preposition à, and then the verb dire. So it's the infinitive form. Okay, so, je suis content de partir. Elle est fière de moi. C'est plein de vitamines. C'est facile à dire. Okay, so remember, adjectif, préposition, verbe, adjectif, préposition, pronom personnel tonique, adjectif, préposition, substantif ou nom, adjectif, préposition, verbe à l'infinitif. So, this is the thing that you should really remember, adjectif, préposition, nom, infinitif, and then in most of the cases, it will be de. L'adjectif avec que est une proposition complétive. Okay, so let's see now how it will go. So, remember that it will be possible in some cases to construct or to make a structure that will have l'adjectif and then que after, so remember this que means that, okay, and then it will be followed by une proposition complétive, so it does mean that at least one verb or one verb and then complements, okay, so subject, verb and complements, so adjectif and then que, that, and followed by une proposition complétive. Okay, the important thing is that most of the adjectives won't match these requirements, so it won't be possible to make this structure with most of them, but we're talking in that case about les adjectifs qui expriment un sentiment, so the adjectives that will express feelings. Okay, un sentiment, a feeling. Alright, so we will see a few examples. And the first one is être content que. Okay, so you can see that you've got the verb to be, and then here you've got your adjective, and it's followed by que. Okay, and the rest should come. Être désolé que. Exactly the same thing, you've got désolé and then que. Être bouleversé que. Être choqué que, être indigné que. Okay, so, être content que, être désolé que, être bouleversé que, être choqué que, être indigné que. Être fier que, être embêté que, être ennuyé que, être gêné que, être embarrassé que. Alright, so exactly the same structures. You've got your adjectives, they are followed by que, okay, and then the rest should come. Être fier que, être embêté que, être ennuyé que, être gêné que, être embarrassé que. Être furieux que, être ravi que, être confus que, être déçu que, être mécontent que, être furieux que, être ravi que, être confus que, être déçu que, être mécontent que. One thing important. If you look at this sentence, je suis content que je sois ici. It is a common mistake. Okay? So it's not possible to have here in the first part, je, and here in the second part, the same person. Okay? So, je suis content que je sois ici is not possible. In that case, you will have to change the structure and you will have to put je suis content, and then you don't continue with que and the sentence, but then you will put your verb at the infinitive. Je suis content d'être ici. Okay, this is a common mistake, okay, so try to remember that. So it does work for je, but then I've been putting this example as well, because it's exactly the same. If it's tu, and then tu, if it's il, and il, if it's nous, well, basically, if you've got the same person in the first and the second part, then it doesn't work, okay? So, tu es content que tu sois ici, it's not possible, but then, tu es content d'être ici. Okay, je suis content que tu sois ici. Je suis désolé que tu sois ici. Je suis bouleversé que tu sois ici. Je suis choqué que tu sois ici. Je suis indigné que tu sois ici. Okay, so in all these structures, you can see that it works because you've got je in the first part and then you get tu in the second part. So they are not the same person, so it's possible. Okay? So je suis content que, je suis désolé que, je suis bouleversé que, je suis choqué que, je suis indigné que. If you noticed, we are talking here about les adjectifs qui expriment un sentiment. And maybe it rings a bell because, unfortunately for you, when we're talking about this structure, que, and then you express a feeling, un sentiment, then you will have to put le subjonctif right after, okay? And that's probably what you noticed, but then now you can see it more clearly that in all the structures that, or the sentences I've been putting previously, here, here, and here, we've got le subjonctif. Okay, so keep in mind that for this type of structures, when you put this adjective that will express a feeling, then it's followed by que, and then you've got a structure after, you should put your verb here and here at the subjonctif form. Okay? L'adjectif avec la préposition à et l'infinitif. Okay, so we'll end probably with this video or maybe the next one, this big series concerning les adjectifs, okay, but then I thought it might be useful to actually make this video regarding l'adjectif followed by la préposition à and then un verbe à l'infinitif, so a verb that should be at the basic form, so this infinitive form, okay? And then that, I mean, you should keep in mind that it is really, really, really common. So we use that quite often in French, okay? So adjective followed by a and then a verb, okay? So we'll see few examples in this video. The first one, for instance, facile à faire. Difficile à annoncer. Simple à construire. Amusant à regarder. Triste à écouter. Okay, so if you look carefully in each situations, you've got this first part. It's an adjective. Facile, difficile, simple, amusant, triste. And then you put the preposition à. And then you put your verb at the infinitive form. Faire, annoncer, construire, regarder, écouter. Okay, so facile à faire, difficile à annoncer, simple à construire, amusant à regarder, triste à écouter. Okay, so let's put sentences now. Un travail facile à faire. Okay, so we had already this facile à faire, but then you just put a word or a noun before. Un travail, a work, facile à faire. Une information, so news, difficile à annoncer. Une maison, a house, simple à construire. Un film, a movie, amusant à regarder. Une histoire, a story, triste à écouter. All right, so it's actually quite simple, and it is quite often in French language. Okay, so keep in mind, adjectif, and then you get la préposition à, and then you put your verb at the infinitive form. Some adjectives, especially if you want to describe a person, décrire une personne, and it's the first part because the series or the list is quite long, so I didn't want to make a too long video. So it's the first part, and then we'll do the second part a bit later. Okay, so let's start now. Accueillant, accueillante. Okay, so I will pronounce first the masculine form, then the feminine form. So masculine, accueillant. Accueillante. Actif, active. Affectueux, affectueuse. Agile, and then it's the same form for the feminine form. Agréable, same thing here. So, accueillant, accueillante. Actif, active. Affectueux, affectueuse. Agile, agréable. Agressif, agressive. Aimable. Ambitieux, ambitieuse. Amusant, amusante. Antipathique. Agressif, agressive. Aimable, ambitieux, ambitieuse, amusant, amusante, antipathique, arrogant, arrogante, astucieux, astucieuse, aventureux, aventureuse, beau, belle, bête, arrogant, arrogante, astucieux, astucieuse, aventureux, aventureuse, beau, belle, bête, câlin, câline, calme, charmant, charmante. Compétitif, compétitive. Complexé, complexé. So you just add this final a, but then for the feminine form, it's phonetically it's the same as the masculine form. Okay? So, câlin, câline, calme, charmant, charmante, compétitif, compétitive. Whoops, sorry, it was complexé. I'm going too fast. Courageux, courageuse. Créatif, créative. Curieux, curieuse. Débrouillard, débrouillarde. Décidé. And then décidé, feminine form, but then you don't hear the final a. Okay? Courageux, courageuse. Créatif, créative. Curieux, curieuse. Débrouillard, débrouillarde. Décidé, décidé. Désagréable. Discipliné, discipliné. Drôle. Dynamique. Égoïste. Désagréable. Discipliné, discipliné. Okay, so you add this final E, you don't pronounce it. Drôle. Dynamique. Égoïste. Élégant, élégante. Embarrassé, embarrassé. Same thing here, final E, you don't pronounce it. Ennuyeux, ennuyeuse. Enthousiaste. Étrange. Élégant, élégante. Embarrassé, embarrassé. Ennuyeux, ennuyeuse. Enthousiaste. Étrange. Être de bonne humeur. Être de mauvaise humeur. Excentrique, exigeant, extraverti, être de bonne humeur, être de mauvaise humeur, excentrique, exigeant, exigeante, extraverti, extraverti. Faible, faux, fausse, fidèle, fier, fier. So you write them differently, but then phonetically it's exactly the same. Fier, fier. Fort, forte. Okay. Faible, faux, fausse, fidèle. Fier, fier, fort, forte. Fou, folle. Franc, franche. Gauche. Généreux, généreuse. Gentil, gentille. Fou, folle. Franc, franche. Gauche. Généreux, généreuse. Gentil, gentille. Grand, grande. Heureux, heureuse. Honnête. Hostile. Hypocrite. Grand, grande, heureux, heureuse, honnête, hostile, hypocrite, idéaliste, idiot, idiote. Imposant, imposante. Indépendant, indépendante. Indiscret, indiscrète. Idéaliste. Idiot, idiote. Imposant, imposante. Indépendant, indépendante. Indiscret, indiscrète. Ingrat, ingrate. Insensible, insupportable. Généreux, intelligent, intelligente. Ingrat, insensible, insupportable, généreux, intelligent, intelligente. So les temps composés, so the compound tenses, and especially la forme négative, so the negative form with compound tenses. So, if you remember, la forme négative in French, if you want to express the negative form, then normally you get two parts, deux éléments. The first one is ne, and then normally the verb is coming after, and the second part is pas. Okay, this is how normally we construct that. Keep in mind that ne will be modified if the verb is starting with a vowel, or in some cases, not all the verbs starting with ash, but most of them. Okay, so let's see how it will go with the present, for instance. So you take je suis, okay, I am, and then basically it's quite simple to make the negative form as you, well, if you remember what I just said, you get this first part ne, okay, then you put the verb, and after that you put this pas, je ne suis pas. Okay, if you take this future proche form, so it's quite interesting because it's not a real future. It's I am, like in English, I am going to be, okay? So in French, we just construct it in the same way. We use the verb aller, aller is to go, okay? And then after that, we put the second verb at the infinitive. So je vais être, I am going to be, okay? Je vais être. But then the interesting thing is that in this structure, well, clearly you've got two verbs. The first one is aller, and it's conjugated, but then the second one is être, okay? It doesn't change anything because you will have to put ne and pas before and after your first verb, okay? So, je ne vais pas être, if you make the liaison, je ne vais pas être. So let's see now how it will behave when we have this passé composé form. So it's a compound tense, you can see it here. So you've got only one form, so it's j'ai été. So you get avoir first, and then you get this participe passé form. Okay, so j'ai été, and the negative form will be je n'ai pas été. Okay, so you will put your ne first before avoir, so you can see that, as I said here, you've got to take away the e here, je n'ai, and then you put your pas, and you put after that your participe passé. Okay, a common mistake is normally to put this pas, so the second part of the negative form, after this participe passé. Okay, think about that and try to remember that it should be before and after avoir in that case, and it can be être as well in other cases. Okay, so for instance, for the plus que parfait, another compound tense, it will be exactly the same. J'avais été, je n'avais pas été. Okay, so before and after avoir. Futur antérieur, well, it will be exactly the same thing. J'aurais été, je n'aurais pas été, je n'aurais pas été. Conditionnel passé, another compound tense, it will behave exactly the same way. J'aurais été, je n'aurais pas été. something quite important, and it's oral French. So I'm not talking about this formal oral, but I'm talking about, well, this French that you can hear when you are walking in the street and then people are speaking in an informal way. And in that case, quite often, they will actually only use one part for this negative form. And this part that they will use will be the pas. Okay, so they will take away the ne and they will only keep this pas. Keep in mind that it is informal French. So it's spoken French, it's not in formal situation, because of course in formal situation you will have to keep the two parts, okay? But then if you are listening to, well, youngsters, they won't use the first ne part, okay? So let's see how it will look like. Je suis, okay, will become je suis pas. Futur proche, je vais être, will become, sorry, je vais pas être. Passé composé, j'ai été, will become, j'ai pas été. Plus que parfait, j'avais été, will become, j'avais pas été. Futur antérieur, j'aurais été, will become, j'aurais pas été. Conditionnel passé, j'aurais été, will become, j'aurais pas été. So remember, la forme négative, normally two parts. When we are talking about this informal oral French, then one part, okay? When you get the two parts, it's ne and then your verb and pas. And if it's informal, then it's only pas, okay? Les verbes pronominaux, and more precisely, la forme négative avec les verbes pronominaux. Okay, so let's start now. La forme négative, so if you remember it, we've got two parts that normally we need to use if we want to put this negative form. The first one is ne, and then you've got pas. Okay, between the two, you should have your verb. Okay, so let's take an example now. We will take the verb se lever. Okay, so it's un verbe pronominal, se lever, okay, and then at the present form, so je me lève. Se lever is to get up, okay, je me lève, all right, and the question is, where do we need to put ne and pas? Well, look, and it's quite interesting, je, and then ne is coming here, me is here, lève is here, and then pas is coming at the end. Okay, so it's not a big surprise, the position of pas, but then it's normally my students tend to make the mistake to put ne just before lève. Okay, and of course it would be logical, but then unfortunately for you, you should keep in mind that ne is here, and then you've got me lève together. Je ne me lève pas. Okay. For the futur proche, so je vais me lever. Okay, so I am going to get up. Je ne, and then vais pas me lever. So it's actually quite easy when you get this form, because you will have to put ne and then pas before and after the first verb. Okay, and in that case it's vais. So you don't really need to bother about the fact that it should be before this me, okay? But in that case, je ne vais pas me lever, okay? And now let's see with the passé composé. Je me suis levé. Exactly the same thing. Je ne, and then you keep this me suis together, and you put your pas here and levé. Okay, this is quite tricky normally because students tend to mix up and then put the ne before the sui and then maybe the pa at the end. Okay, so keep in mind this is the order, this is the way where things should be. Je ne me suis pas levé. Okay, plus que parfait, so another compound tense. Je m'étais levé. Well, je ne m'étais pas levé. Ok? Futur antérieur, je me serais levé. Je ne me serais pas levé. Ok, so you can see that we follow the same logic in a way because you've got to put this ne first and then me and then the verb are together. Then come the second part of the negative form, sorry, and after that you put your participe passé. Okay? Conditionnel passé, well, exactly the same thing. Je me serais levé. Je ne me serais pas levé. Okay? Keep in mind that actually, as you know, spoken French and written French can be different. And for this section, I will actually present to you this informal way that French people, or not all the French people, but then some French people have to construct the negative form. Okay, because if we're talking about youngsters, for instance, and then, well, the French that you can hear in the streets, normally when we talk about the negative part, they will take the first part away. And then you've got je me lève. If you want to put the negative form, then you will only put this pas at the end. Okay? This is informal. It's not formal French. It does mean that if you want to write, if you want to communicate with officials or in some serious situations, you should definitely use the two parts of the negative form. Okay, the important thing is to, well, listen. If you hear that the persons that you are talking to or you are talking with are not using this first part, then, well, why not? You know, just follow them and you can drop if you want the first part. Okay, je me lève pas. Okay, then futur proche, so je vais me lever. Then, je vais pas me lever. Ok? Passé composé. Je me suis levé. Je me suis pas levé. Plus que parfait. Je m'étais levé. Will become. Je m'étais pas levé. Futur antérieur. Je me serais levé. Je me serais pas levé. Conditionnel passé. Je me serais levé. Je me serais pas levé. Okay? So remember, la forme négative, you should have two parts, or then it's possible to see one part. Okay? When you've got two parts, it's ne and then pas. Okay? Or then only pas, but then we are here dealing with informal French, so be careful, don't use that in all the situations. L'infinitif and then les modifications, and more precisely, we will talk about reflexive verbs. Okay, so infinitive. So let's start right now. And I've been thinking that it would be interesting to pick two verbs and maybe to take, well, actually, regarder first and then se regarder. Okay, so regarder means to look, and then se regarder, so it's the reflexive verb, so to look at yourself. Okay, so let's see now, because the idea is that when you've got two verbs, actually, we take the futur proche as an example. So the futur proche, remember, it's this fake future, in a way, when you use this I am going to, and something is coming after. So we do the same in French. We use aller, to go, and then you put the second verb at the infinitive. So it's normally quite simple if you've got a normal verb in a way, but then when we start to construct that with the reflexive verbs, it can be a bit tricky or it can be a bit strange at the beginning. So that's the reason why we'll see that together. So first person je, and then, well, actually, if you want to use this future proche form, I am going to look, it's quite simple because you just put your subject, you put your verb here, to go, conjugated at the present form, je vais, and then you put the infinitive form, regarder. Okay, so in this situation, it is quite simple. But then the question is, how would you put that if you would use this reflexive verb, se regarder? Because the common mistake that actually my students tend to make is that they will put je vais, and clearly they will put the infinitive se regarder, which is logical in a way. It's a logical mistake, but then unfortunately for you, non, 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 it should be like that, je vais, and then se will have to be modified according to, well, here the subject. So here the subject is at the first person, so je, and then you will have to put me for the first person, regarder. Je vais me regarder. Okay? So here, je vais regarder, I am going to look. Je vais me regarder, I am going to look at myself. Okay? So that's the reason why here you will have to put this me and not se. Okay? So you should keep that in mind because it will change, of course, for tu as well. So, tu vas regarder, I mean, it's quite simple here. Tu vas, and then te regarder. Okay, so te for the second person. Il va regarder. And good news for you, it's actually quite simple. Il va se regarder. Okay, so for the third person, it will be se. Elle va regarder. And then, same thing, elle va se regarder. Well, because elle is also the third person of the singular. And then on as well, on va regarder, on va se regarder. Okay, so now for the first person of the plural, nous, nous allons regarder, and then it will become nous allons nous regarder. Vous, vous allez regarder, vous allez vous regarder. And then good news, third person of the plural, ils vont regarder, ils vont se regarder. Elles vont regarder, elles vont se regarder. All right, so, je, tu, and then il, elle, on. Keep in mind that if you construct this structure in which you get first a verb and then a second verb at the infinitive and it's a reflexive verb, then it should be me, and then the rest at the infinitive. If it's tu, it should be te, and then the rest at the infinitive. Il, elle, on, it should be se, and the rest at the infinitive. Nous, vous, il, elle, it should be nous, vous, and then se. Le passé surcomposé. Okay, so le passé surcomposé, and we start right now. So in this video, first we will see l'utilisation of le passé surcomposé, and then after that we will see la formation. Okay, so first, when do we use, so l'utilisation, and then la formation, how do we construct this passé surcomposé. Okay, so we can start now with l'utilisation. So keep in mind that we will use le passé surcomposé pour exprimer des faits qui se sont passés avant d'autres faits passés exprimés au passé composé. So it may look a bit difficult that way, but then let's say that you want to express something in the past, and normally you will use this passé composé form that we've been using and we've been seeing previously. Okay, but then if you want to express some facts that have been happening before these past events, in that case, well, you will use, or you should use, le passé surcomposé. Well, actually, it's not really the case, because we've been seeing that we've got this plus que parfait tense, okay? And to be totally honest, yes, the second thing here, this passé surcomposé is nowadays quite rare. So, utilisation assez rare, okay? But then keep in mind that l'utilisation est plus fréquente dans le sud de la France. So if you travel, if you go in the south of France, then they will tend to use it a bit more often. But it is quite rare nowadays because people tend to use this plus que parfait instead of le passé surcomposé. Okay, but anyway, it does exist. It is used. Okay, so we will see in this video how to make it. All right, so let's see the timeline. And then let's imagine that this is the present. Okay, so this is now. And then we want to express something in the past, so we will use le passé surcomposé, sorry, le passé composé here. Okay, and then if you want to, as I said, express something that happened before this passé composé, so it's le passé surcomposé. Okay, so the present, le présent, and then the past, le passé composé, and even before, le passé surcomposé. Okay, so here is an example. Dès qu'il a eu bu son café, il est parti au travail. Okay, so it's a strange sentence maybe, but then let's have a look at it. And the first thing that we should spot here is this a eu bu. And then the second thing is est parti. Okay, so the first thing that we can see here, this a eu bu, okay, it's actually this passé surcomposé form. And then, the second form here is the passé composé. Okay, so, dès qu'il a eu bu son café, so this thing has been happening before, so he has been drinking his coffee. Then, okay, something that happens after, but it's still in the past, okay, il est parti au travail. Okay, so, the first event, okay, au passé surcomposé, and the second event here, au passé composé. So let's see how to make this passé surcomposé. Few examples first. So, first sentence, j'ai mangé au restaurant, it's le passé composé, okay, as we saw, you use whether avoir or être, okay, in most of the cases, you will use avoir. You put that at the present form, and then after that you put this form that we call participe passé. Okay, so this is here, le passé composé. Okay, so if you want to make le passé surcomposé, so it's an example here, j'ai eu mangé au restaurant. So you can see that the difference between the two, actually this manger form, so the participe passé, this past participle, doesn't change. So, no changes here, okay? But this is this first part that will change. So if you can notice, in that case here, you've got avoir, and it's at the present form. And if you look carefully here, you've got avoir at the passé composé form. Okay, let's take a second example here. Tu as regardé la télévision. Okay, so exactly the same concept, the first sentence here is at the passé composé, so you get this avoir at the present tense, and then you get here the participe passé. Tu as regardé la télévision. I've got some problems with my mouse, sorry. And then the second sentence, tu as eu regardé la télévision. Okay, so we can see that it's exactly the same situation. We've got this regarder form, and it's exactly the same, so you don't really need to bother about that. And it's the first part that will change, okay, because here, for the passé composé, you've got this verb avoir at the present, and here, for this passé surcomposé, well, actually, you've got avoir at the passé composé form, okay? And it will be exactly the same thing in the last example, but then I wanted to take a verb, so aller, that will require être, you know, at the passé composé. Okay, so il est allé au travail. Okay, and in that case, remember exactly the same thing. So you put être instead of avoir because that is one of these exceptions that will require être to make the passé composé. It is here at the present form. And here for this passé surcomposé, well, we will see exactly the same thing. We've got aller here, so the participe passé doesn't change. And then this first part here, well, actually, it will be the verb être at the passé composé form. Okay, so I hope it's clear. I know it's a bit difficult at the beginning, but then keep in mind that the way to make this passé composé, it's actually quite simple. So first, you will use this avoir, okay, in most of the cases, of course. And then this avoir should be at the passé composé. Then you will put, as we saw, this participe passé form, and you will get your passé surcomposé. Remember, in some cases, as we saw for aller, you will use être, but still, it's exactly the same concept. Être should be at the passé composé form. Then you will put your participe passé, so exactly the same concept, and you will get your passé surcomposé form. Okay, so let's see the exceptions. So we saw that we've got aller. We do have arriver. So aller is to go, arriver, arrive. Descendre, descend or go down. Devenir, to become. Entrer, to come in or to enter. Monter, to go up. Mourir, to die. Naître, to born or be born. Partir, to leave. Rester, to stay. Retourner, to return or to come back. Sortir, to go out. Tomber, to fall. And then venir, to come. Okay, so remember that all these verbs will require être. Okay, and obviously some verbs will be constructed based on these verbs. Okay, so logically they will also require the verb être. Okay, remember also that the verb, as we say, les verbes pronominaux, okay, so the verb that will be constructed with this se in front of them, se regarder, or then it could be s apostrophe if you had a vowel, s'appeler, se présenter. So all these verbs, les verbes pronominaux, will also require être for this passé surcomposé form. Okay? So let's see now, and let's try to refresh a little bit, avoir and être at the passé composé, because that's the part that we will need to use when we construct this passé surcomposé. So avoir at the passé composé goes like that. J'ai eu, tu as eu, il, and then elle, or on even, a eu, nous avons eu, vous avez eu, ils ont eu, elles ont eu. Okay, so it will be our first part of this passé composé, passé surcomposé. And then the second part will be être, so in some cases, as we saw previously. And être goes like that. J'ai été, tu as été, il, elle, or then on a été, nous avons été, vous avez été, ils ont été, elles ont été. Okay, so same thing here. So it will be our first part for the exceptions that we saw previously. Remember that the second part, so we talked about this participe passé form, Well, actually, it will be quite simple for the regular verbs. So the first group of regular verb is the, well, or is the group that will include all the verbs ending with er. Exception is aller, as we saw, but then it's actually quite simple. Have a look at that. You've got the infinitive form here ending with er. Okay, so this is the basic form of the verb. Okay, you just take this er away and you will replace it with accent aigu. And here you get this participe passé form. So parler will become parler. Phonetically it's the same, but then you write it differently. Regarder will become regarder. Okay, same rule. And then aller will become aller. So even if aller doesn't belong to this first group of regular verbs, actually when we talk about the construction of this participe passé form, well, it's quite regular as well. So nothing tricky there. The second group, okay, remember, the verbs ending with er, okay, but not all of them, because it's a common mistake, not all of them are following these rules, because we've got another group of er verbs that will belong to the third group, so irregular verbs. But, I mean, this, actually, we're talking in that case about the regular verbs ending with er, okay? And it will be quite simple as well, because, have a look, you've got the basic form here, choisir, er, okay? And then you just take it away and you replace it with I. So you will get, so choisir will become choisi. Then finir will become fini. Unir will become uni. Alright, so it's not really difficult. So if we're talking about the regular verbs from the first group here and the second group here, they are quite easy to make if we talk about this participe passé form. Okay, so let's see now the third group, few exceptions, few categories and subcategories. So, but then connaître will become connu. Okay, voir will become vu. Partir, even if it belongs to the third group, well, it's actually quite simple, it will become parti. Rire will become ri. Écrire will become écrit. Dire will become dit. Mettre will become mis. Prendre will become pris. Okay? So let's see few examples, or we'll take the verb parler, so quite regular verb, and we'll put that at the passé surcomposé. Okay, so remember we had the first part here, so avoir at the passé composé, so we've been saying that, and then the second part, this participe passé, you just put it here. J'ai eu parlé. Tu as eu parlé. Il, elle, on a eu parlé. Nous avons eu parlé. Vous avez eu parlé. Ils ont eu parlé, elles ont eu parlé. Okay? And you can see that as we are constructing this passé surcomposé form with avoir, in all the cases, we will keep this accent aigu here, so we don't put any mark for the feminine or for the plural here. Okay? So it will be all the time et here. But then, remember that it will behave exactly the same way as all the compound tenses if you use a verb, like aller, for instance, that will require être and not avoir. So in that case, you will have to put, like here, the feminine form at the end of your participe passé. So remember that is the mark of the feminine, okay? So, il a été allé, but then you don't put anything because it's the masculine, so you should put the basic form. In that case, you get elle, okay? And then, well, it's a feminine, singular feminine, you should put this at the end of your participe passé. Phonetically, you don't hear it. It goes like allé, so exactly the same thing as here, or the same way. So, elle a été allée. So, if we respect the logic, then for the masculine plural, we should add at the end this S. So, S is the mark of the plural, okay? So, ils ont été allés. And then logically as well, if we put the feminine and the plural form, so elle, so first we will add a mark of the feminine, then s mark of the plural, and you will get elles ont été allées. So the good news is that phonetically it's aller here, aller, aller, aller. So it's the same. You don't pronounce this final you don't pronounce this final s here. Okay, so it's exactly the same. But keep in mind that if you want to write correctly, you should put them. So if we put the full form, j'ai été allé, okay, with the option of the feminine. Tu as été allé, option of the feminine as well. Il a été allé, so in that case, it's the masculine form. Elle a été allée, and here it's the feminine form. Nous avons été allés, so you put the plural at the end. Vous avez été allé. Ils ont été allés, okay, and in that case you've got the plural only, so masculine because you don't have anything else, and then elles ont été allées, here you've got the feminine plural, so E and S. So let's remember how to construct this passé surcomposé. Well, actually the first part, and in almost all the cases it will be avoir, okay, and avoir should be at the passé composé form. Then you will put your participe passé form as usual for all these compound tenses in French. So, and you will get this passé surcomposé, okay. In some cases, as we saw, we can use être, okay, but then the rules stay the same, so it should be at the passé composé. Then you will put your participe passé form, and you will get your passé surcomposé. Okay, so keep in mind that it is quite rare nowadays. I mean, to be really honest, it is quite rare, but still, that's the way it works. And then if you read, if you hear any passé surcomposé, well, you will know what they are. Okay, les participes passés irréguliers, because they are quite important, especially if you want to make some compound tenses, or if you want to use some compound tenses, you will have to use les participes passés, and in many cases you'll use irregular verbs, so we'll need to cover them right now. So the concept is quite simple. We will first put this verb at the infinitive form, so the basic form of the verb. Then we'll have the translation, la traduction in English. And after that, we will have le participe passé, okay, so the form that we want to remember. So let's start right now. Absoudre, absous, abstenir, abstenu, abstraire, abstrait. Accroître, accru, acquérir, acquis, adjoindre, adjoint, admettre, admis, advenir, advenu, apercevoir, aperçu, apparaître, apparu, appartenir, appartenu, apprendre, appris, asseoir, assis, astreindre, astreint, atteindre, atteint, attraire, attrait, avenir, avenu, avoir, eu, boire, bu, braire, bray, bruire, bruit. Circoncire, circoncis. Circonscrire, circonscrit. Clore, clos. Commettre, commis. Comparaître, comparu. Complaire, complu. Comprendre, compris. Compromettre, compromis. Concevoir, conçu. Conclure, conclu. Confire, confie. Conjoindre, conjoint. Connaître, connu. Conquérir, conquis. Contenir, contenu. Contraindre, contraint. Contredire, contredit. Contrefaire, contrefait. Contrevenir, contrevenu. Convenir, convenu. Coudre, cousu. Couvrir, couvert. Craindre, craint. Croire, cru. Croître, cru. Décevoir, déçu. Découdre, décousu. Découvrir, découvert. Décrire, décrit. Décroître, décru. Dédire, dédit. Défaire, défait. Déjoindre, déjoint. Démettre, démis. Dépeindre, dépeint. Déplaire, déplu. Déprendre, dépris. Désapprendre, désappris. Déteindre, déteint. Détenir, détenu. Devenir, devenu. Devoir, dû. Dire, dit. Disconvenir, disconvenu. Disjoindre, disjoint. Disparaître, disparu. Dissoudre, dissous. Distraire, distrait. Éclore, éclos. Écrire, écrit. Élire, élu, en boire, en bu, émettre, émis, déconfire, déconfit, émouvoir, ému, empreindre, emprunt, enceindre, enceint, enclore, enclos, enfreindre, enfreint, enjoindre, enjoint, enquérir, enquis, entreapercevoir, entreaperçu, entreapercevoir, entreaperçu, entrenuire, entrenuit, entremettre, entremis, entreprendre, entrepris, entretenir, entretenu, entrouvrir, entrouvert, éprendre, épris, éteindre, éteint, étreindre, étreint, être, été, exclure, exclu, extraire, extrait, faire, fait, feindre, fin, forclore, forclos, frire, fri, geindre, geint.